Hi again, everyone. Welcome back to Comcast Newsmakers. I'm Maggie Sciura, and we are coming to you today from the Tech Museum of Innovation, affectionately known as the Tech, in downtown San Jose. World-renowned and ours. And we wanted to introduce it that way because our guest for the next few moments is a gentleman who happens to be the president of the Tech Museum of Innovation. It's Mr. Tim Ritchie. And welcome. I know you've been in San Jose for about a year now, helming this incredible institution. And what are your impressions and how's it going?
Well, my impressions is that there are so many assets in this community that it's like being a kid in a candy store. We can do so much good at the Tech, and the Tech does a lot of good. And the other impression is that the future is really bright because the place of museums and society will even get bigger, and they'll get bigger here at the Tech.
It's a difficult thing to do, starting a museum. We wanted this so badly in this area. It has been created. It's beautiful and amazing. Where do we go from here? How do we get people, not just here, but from everywhere, to appreciate it for what it is?
The Tech began with a really compelling vision, and that is that people would come here and experience the spirit of Silicon Valley. The mission is for the Tech to inspire the innovator in everyone. And to grow into that mission will be really exciting in the years to come, because we will grow from a traditional museum experience to really where the museum becomes a community resource. So it'll be museum as resource, and that's what's going to begin to happen now. Most of those changes at the beginning will happen on our lower level. We just created something called the Tech Studio. And the Tech Studio is a very flexible space where the community can come and actually use the space to do amazing things. There's flexible tables, there's whiteboards, there's Wi-Fi, there's a fabrication lab. So for instance, the past three weekends, we've had community groups come in and use the Tech Studio to do science and technology programming for kids. Now that was the community coming to us to use us as a resource to do what they do, which just happens to be our mission. So now imagine multiplying that times 10, 30,000 square feet of flexible space the community can use to have a deep engagement with science, technology, engineering, and math, but also to have flexible spaces where they can work as groups, can collaborate, can solve problems, can innovate, can start businesses. This is a different kind of museum. This is a museum as community resource, and that's where I want us to move.
And incubator of sorts.
Incubator, problem solver, collaborator, social space, community resource.
And at the same time, the exhibits that people have come to know and love and new and traveling and so forth will continue?
Yes, and the exhibits on the second floor, for instance, would be more traditional exhibits where we are right now. So the impacts of innovation and beautiful exhibits where people see how technology benefits humanity. But in the lower level, the exhibit experience itself will be this deep experience with applied technology. So for instance, this summer we'll have a new robotics exhibit, but it won't be people observing robots or pushing a button. It will be people building robots to solve problems, getting better and better and better at building their own. And then in the context, they can learn about the career connections to robots. They can learn about some of the ethical questions concerning robots. They can see how robots are changing the face of productivity in America. So that's a design challenge downstairs.
So rather than the usual invitation, we'll be saying, get in here and create. Thank you so much, Tim Ritchie.
And my pleasure.
Come back often, and we'll talk about what's happening at the Tech. That's it for now, everybody. I'm Maggie Sciura. We'll see you next time.